In the practice of meditation, one of the important things which we have seen is the posture. The next important thing is to allow the breath to be settled. And settling of the breath does not mean that relaxing to a point where the person falls to sleep. Sleep can occur under these two or three circumstances, under the two or three conditions, according to what Vidyaranya Swami has shown or said. One is, if the person has had incomplete sleep, nidra shesh, if the digestion is not good, then also there can be the residual sleep is one, the undigested or indigestion can be one of the cause, and the third cause is food which can be digested but is still not digested. So heaviness in the body, it can be the cause of when all the toxins are not washed away, then this can happen. So there is one method which the yogis follow, and it is called as ushapan, to drink large glasses of slightly warm water, not lukewarm or not cold, but on the warmer side, on the rising scale of warmth, one should drink before using the toilet or going to the bathroom, and flush out all the residue which needs to be thrown out of the body. This is called as ushapana, to drink that good quantity, at least 200 ml of water, hot water or warmer water, right in the morning, in the early morning. That will cause the bowels to move and will help you have clean bowels. So thus, when the body is now light, now you are in a way prepared to sit. The sitting posture, the backbone straight. And now the Upanishad says, when you are thus settled, bring your attention to the center of the heart, the sternum, and then bow down mentally at the lotus feet of the teacher. Swagurum pranamya. Now thus seated, and having sought permission from the teacher to meditate, having sought his blessings to meditate, one should begin. Let this take as long as it has to take, whether it takes 2 months, 3 months, 6 months. Let it. We are not in a hurry to gather stranger experiences. We are over here. The whole process of meditation for us is an exercise. An exercise to create a mind which now is prepared for the vision of the self. Therefore, on the seat of meditation, the first thing that you do is, after having bowed down to the teacher, mentally bow down to Mother Earth. The place on which you are sitting. After that, the asana that you are going to use also has certain regulations about it. Kusha is the grass, a mat made out of that kusha, is generally told, on which a woolen blanket, in the olden days they used to use the deer skin, etc. A woolen blanket or just a blanket, and a cotton piece of cloth. Thus it is three-layered. The seat is three-layered. Seated on that, now keep the body steady. Lock the hands, palms of the hands, palms together, or let those palms rest on your knees. As you are comfortable keeping the hands, and whenever you find that your backbone is losing its straight rise, slowly nudge it to rise again. Otherwise, when the shoulders start slopping inside, the lungs start collapsing. And when the lungs are collapsed or folded, the air in the body, in the lungs, will be in lesser quantity. So we need air in its to the fullest capacity of this lungs to begin with, so that it can provide energy to the brain. And keep it active in a positive way. Now, on the seat of meditation, say to yourself that there is nothing in this world that I want. Absolutely nothing. I do not even desire anyone's approval, anyone's appreciation. Nothing is desired. I want nothing from this world. At least as long as I am on the seat of meditation, I want nothing from this world. Wanting nothing from this world is your freedom. Is your freedom. Wanting something means it is a bargain. And in that bargain, you are exchanging freedom for that object. Therefore, as long as I am on the seat of meditation, I want nothing. This wanting nothing is sannyas. On the seat of meditation, you are a sannyasi, wanting nothing. And then you are bound to discover that though I am saying I want nothing, several things keep coming to me saying that this is what is wanted. How are you saying you want nothing? The exercise presently is to look at all that is in your demand list. Look at it closely, examine it. And then ask a question at that moment as you are looking at it. Is it something that is so badly and truly wanted by me? And you will discover the answer if you are really sincerely doing that exercise. The answer would be not really, not really. And you will be surprised that we have filled our life, our activities, our mind with so many unnecessary things. More clearly, when you will start seeing what is unnecessary, to that point, now the mind is becoming free. This recognizing this freedom is the birth of a spiritual aspirant. Once again, having seated properly, one should bow down to the lotus feet of the teacher. Then after, declare your resolve to practice meditation. Then after, talk to yourself and say that I want nothing from anyone, anything. More clearly you see this, intense will be your freedom. Aradhana, please keep the alarm or some track and tell us when it is going to be 7 o'clock by Indian standards.
Okay, Swamiji.
Keep your body steady. Observe the breath, how it becomes steady. And then this resolution.
Thank you.
Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanta Shanta Shantihi Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashakritau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Gururatmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Mahadeva Mahadeva Mahadeva